Hello all, welcome to my channel Weight Lectures. Today we will discuss multiple choice questions on livestock productions and management. Question number first, binomial system of classification was given by option A, Linnaeus, option B, Lamarck, option C, Darwin, and option D, Linnaeus. The right answer is Linnaeus. Actually, Lamarck gave theory of inheritance of acquired character, while Darwin gave the theory of biological evolution by natural selections, and Linnaeus known for his invention, that is the stethoscope. Question number second, which of the following is the non-ruminant animal? Option A, cattle. Option B, goat. Option C, pig. Option D, deer. The right answer is option C, that is pig. Actually, ruminants include those animals which have four stomach, that is rumen, reticulum, abomasum and omasum, and it's mainly include cattle, deer, bison, buffalo, goat and sheep, while non-ruminant includes pig, poultry, elephant, hippopotamus. Other than ruminant and non-ruminant, there is pseudo-ruminant which has only three stomach, that is rumen, reticulum and abomasum. They lacking omasum. It's mainly include family Camelidae, which includes camel, alpacas and llamas. Question number 3. Which animal has minimum chromosome number? Option A, pig. Option B, sheep. Option C, goat. Option D, horse. The right answer is option A, pig. Actually, the pig has lowest, that is 38 chromosome number among all the option. The cattle and goat both has 60 number of chromosome. Riverine and water buffalo both has 50 number of chromosome, while song buffalo has 48 number of chromosome. Pig and cat both has 38 number of chromosome. Dog and fowl both has 78 number chromosome, and camel has 74 number chromosome. Dog and fowl has highest number of chromosome. Elephant has 56 number of chromosome. Sheep has 54 number of chromosome, while horse has 64 number chromosome, and donkey has 62 number chromosome, and mule has the 63 number chromosome, because mule is the cross of horse and dog, so their chromosome number is also in between both them. Okay, question number 4. Act of parturition in cat is known as option A, kidding. Option B, queening. Option C, kindling. Option D, foaling. The right answer is option B, that is queening. Here is the list of all the animals, and other side there is the act of parturition of respective animal. In case of cattle, buffalo, camel, it's called calving. In case of bird, chicken, goose, turkey, it's called hatching. In case of horse, it's foaling. In case of goat, it's kidding. In case of sheep, it's lambing. In case of swine, it's farrowing. In case of dog, it's whelping. In case of cat, it's queening. In case of rabbit, it is kindling. Question number 5. Group of animals known as cloder in which animal? Option A, rabbit. Option B, guinea pig. Option C, cat. Option D, horse. The right answer is cat. In case of cattle and pig, it's called herds and or drove. In case of buffalo, it's herd. In case of horse, it's herd or stable. In case of goat, it's called trips. In case of sheep, it's flock or herder. In case of dog, it's kennel. In case of cat, it's cloder. In case of chicken or turkey, it's flock. In case of goose, it's gaggle. In case of rabbit, it's colony. In case of camel, it's herd or tola. Question number 6. Act of mating in sheep is known as option A, tooping. Option B, serving. Option C, covering. Option D, coupling. The right answer is option A, tooping. In case of cattle, buffalo, goat, the act of mating of these animal called service. In case of horse, it's called covering. In case of sheep, it's tooping. And in case of pig, it's coupling. Question number 7. Young one of cat is known as option A, kid. Option B, baby. Option C, farrow. Option D, kitten. The right answer is kitten. In case of cattle, it's calf. In case of buffalo, we call it buffalo calf. In case of horse, if the young one is less than 1 year of age, either of sex, it's called foal. And if the female young one above 1 year of age, it's called filly. And its male young one above 1 year of age is called colt. In case of swine, it's piglet or short. In case of sheep, it's lamb. In case of goat, it's kid. In case of rabbit or cat, it's kitten. While in case of rabbit, it is also called kit. While in dog, it's pups. In case of chicken, it's chick. In case of goose, it's gosling. In case of turkey, it's poult. In case of camel, if there's a male young one, it's tordia. In case of female young one, it's tordi. T-O-R-D-I, tordi. Okay. Question number 8. Castrated male of horse is known as option A, gelding. Option B, widder. Option C, bullock. Option D, steer. The right answer is A, gelding, or either it is called geld also. Castrated male horse, gelding or geld. Castrated adult sheep called widder or wedder. Ram castrated if after service, it is called shaggy. And if the male sheep that has not been castrated properly, that is known as ridge. While male pig that castrated before reaching the puberty, before reaching the sexual maturity, is called barrow. And male pig if castrated after reaching the puberty, that is called stage. While the bull, castrated bull, is known as steer or bullock. Question number 9. Meat of buffalo is known as option A, beef. Option B, cara beef. Option C, mutton. Option D, chivan. The right answer is B, that is cara beef. While in case of cow, it's called beef if the cow is mature. While in case of, if the meat of that young calf, then it's called veal. In case of buffalo, it's cara beef. In case of sheep, it's mutton. In case of goat, it's chivan. In case of pig, it's pork. In case of hen, it's chicken. In case of deer, it's venison. Question number 10. Which of the following is the family of sheep? Option A, Suidae. Option B, Ovidae. Option D, Bovidae. And option D, Capridae. The right answer is option C, Bovidae. Actually, there are two suborder, that is Perissodactyla and Artiodactyla. Even-footed animals came under suborder Artiodactyla, and under suborder Artiodactyla, there is three families. That is Suidae, Camelidae and Bovidae. Under Suidae, there is only one genus, that is Sus, which include pigs, okay. And Camelidae, it's include genus Camelus and Llama. And actually in under family Bovidae, it's include three genus, that is Capra, which is a genus of goat, Ovis, which is genus of sheep, and Bos, which is genus of like buffalo and cattle. Question number 11. Adult male and female of horse is known as option A, stallion and mares. Option B, stallions and equine. Option C, buck and doe. Option D, tuck and ewe. The right answer is option A, stallion and mare. Actually, in case of cattle, the adult male called bull and female called cow or heifer. In case of buffalo, the adult male called buffalo bull and female called she buffalo. Similarly, in case of horse, the adult male called stallion or stud, or female called mare or dam. In case of swine, that adult male is boar and female is sow or gilt. Sheep, that adult male is buck or ram, or female is ewe or dam. Goat, billy or buck, and female doe and nanny. Dog, male is dog or stud, or female is bitch. Cat is male tom, and female is queen or pushy. Chicken is male cock or rooster, and female is hen or pullet. Goose is a male ganger, female is goose flock. Turkey is male tom, female is hen. Rabbit is male buck, and female is doe. Camel male, that is unt, and female is sand. Okay. The question number 13. Which of the following is the common name of chicken? Actually scientific name of chicken. Option A, Gallus domesticus. Option B, Meleagridis gallopavo. Option C, Oryctolagus cuniculus. Option C, Capra hircus. The right answer is option A, Gallus domesticus. While Indian or humped type cattle, their scientific name is Bos indicus. While exotic or humbless cattle, their scientific name is Bos taurus. Buffalo scientific name is Bos buvalis or Buvalus buvalis. And goat scientific name is Capra hircus. Sheep scientific name is Ovis aris. हॉर्स साइंटिफिक नेम इज इक्वस कैबलस, डंकी साइंटिफिक नेम इज इक्वस असिनस, एंड म्यूल विच इज अ क्रॉस ऑफ हॉर्स एंड डंकी, सो इट्स साइंटिफिक नेम इज इक्वस कैबलस क्रॉस असिनस, जैबरा साइंटिफिक नेम इज इक्वस जैबरा, डोमेस्टिक पिग साइंटिफिक नेम इज सस डोमेस्टिकस, वाइल्ड पिग साइंटिफिक नेम इज सस स्क्रोफा, सिंगल हम्ड कैमल साइंटिफिक नेम इज कैमलस ड्रोमेडारियस, डबल हम्ड कैमल साइंटिफिक नेम इज कैमलस बैक्ट्रियानस, रैबिट साइंटिफिक नेम इज ओरिक्टोलागस कुनिकुलस, चिकन साइंटिफिक नेम इज गैलस डोमेस्टिकस, टर्की साइंटिफिक नेम इज मेलिया ग्रीडिस गलोपाबो, डॉग साइंटिफिक नेम इज कैनिस फैमिलियारिस, कैट साइंटिफिक नेम इज फेलिस कैटस। क्वेश्चन नंबर 14, जेस्टेशन पीरियड ऑफ हॉर्स इज, ऑप्शन ए 363 डेज, ऑप्शन बी 444 डेज, ऑप्शन सी 336 डेज, ऑप्शन डी 633 डेज। द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी 336 डे, ऑल्दो इट इज नॉट एग्जैक्ट बट इट्स नियर टू 11 मंथ 11 डेज अमॉन्ग ऑल ऑप्शंस, सो वी शुड चूज ऑप्शन सी। In case of cow, the gestation period is 9 month 9 day. Buffalo, the gestation period is 10 month 10 day. Horse, gestation period is 11 month 11 day. Goat, gestation period is 5 month 5 day. Sheep, gestation period is 5 days less in 5 month. Actually, in case of goat, 5 month and plus 5 month. In case of sheep, 5 month minus 5 days. Okay. In case of show, that is 3 month 3 week 3 days. In case of dog, it's 2 month 2 days. In case of cat, is 56 to 65 days. In case of camel, it is 1 year 1 month 1 week. In case of elephant, it's 22 month, and in case of rabbit, it's around 1 month. Question number 15, normal body temperature of cattle is 100.8 to 102.4 degree Fahrenheit. Option B 100.4 to 101.7 degree Fahrenheit, option C 100.9 to 102 degree Fahrenheit, option D 101.6 to 103 degree Fahrenheit. The right answer is option A 100.8 to 102.4 degree Fahrenheit. In case of cattle, the normal temperature is 101.4 degree Fahrenheit, which is equivalent to the temperature of cat, which is also 101.4 degree Fahrenheit. In case of buffalo, it's 101. In case of sheep and pig, it's 102.4. In case of horse, it's 100. In case of goat, it's 103.8. In case of rabbit, it's 103.2. In case of dog, it's 102. In case of cat, it's 101.4. In case of camel, it's 97.4. In case of chicken, it's 107.2, which is the highest temperature. Question number 16, which of the following animal have maximum pulse rate? Option A, horse. Option B, cattle. Option C, pig. Option D, dog. The correct answer is option D, dog. Actually, if we see all the animal, then lower the size, body size of the animal, the higher the pulse rate. Let's see, in case of camel is 32 to 50 per minute, in case of horse is 38 to 45 per minute, in case of buffalo it increases 40 to 50 per minute, in case of cow it's 50 to 60 per minute, in case of pig it's 70 to 80 per minute, in case of sheep it's 70 to 90 per minute, in case of goat it's 70 to 90, in case of dog it's 70 to 100 per minute, in case of cat is 100 to 130 per minute, in case of chicken is 120 to 140 per minute. 17. Respiration rate per minute of fowl is option A 20 to 30 per minute, option B 12 to 16 per minute, option C 5 to 12 per minute, option D 40 to 50 per minute. The right answer is option D 40 to 50 per minute. Camel respiration rate is 5 to 12, horse respiration rate is 8 to 12, buffalo respiration rate is 15 to 20, cow respiration rate is 20 to 25. Pig respiration rate is 10 to 16, sheep respiration rate is 12 to 30, goat respiration rate is 12 to 30, dog respiration rate is 15 to 25, cat respiration rate is 18 to 22, and chicken respiration rate is 12 to 28. क्वेश्चन नंबर 18, लेंथ ऑफ स्ट्रोसाइक्लिन गुड इन डेज इज ऑप्शन ए 20, ऑप्शन बी 21, ऑप्शन सी 17, ऑप्शन डी 28. द राइट आंसर इज 20. एक्चुअली द 20 इज नॉट द एग्जैक्ट आंसर. द एग्जैक्ट लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रोसाइक्लिन शिप इज 19 डेज, बट 20 इज नियर इन ऑल अबव ऑप्शन टू 19, सो वी सिलेक्ट 20. In case of camel, it's 25 to 30 days. In case of cow, it's 21 days. Buffalo, same 21. Mare, also 21. Sow, also 21. In case of doe, it's 19 days. In case of ewe, it's 17 days. And while in case of bitch, it's 6 to 7 months because of a longer diestress period. Similarly, in case of cat, is 15 to 21 days. Option number, questions number 19. Length of prostrus in dog in days is ऑप्शन ए 7, ऑप्शन बी 3, ऑप्शन सी 9, ऑप्शन डी 12. द राइट आंसर इज 9. इफ वी सी दैट इन केस ऑफ कैमल, इन केस ऑफ कैट, देर इज नो प्रोस्ट्रस एंड लाइक मेटास्ट्रस पीरियड बिकॉज दीज आर इंड्यूस ओव्यूलेटर एनिमल्स एंड सो देर इज नो प्रोस्ट्रस एंड मेटास्ट्रस, देर इज ओनली स्ट्रस एंड डाइस्ट्रस. And in case of we see that in case of cattle, horse, swine and buffalo, that's the prostrus period is 3 days, while in case of like sheep and goat is 2 days, while in dog it's very higher, that is 9 days. While the stress, if we see the stress in case of camel is 4 to 7 days, in case of cattle is 12 to 24 hours. In case of buffalo, same as like a cattle, that's 1 day. Horse is 6 days. Swine is 2 to 3 days. Sheep is 36 hours. Goat is 48 hours. And dog is 9 days, which is same to the prostrus period of dog. Okay, metastress is absent in dog and camel and cat. Similarly, metastress period is all same for all, almost, that is 3 to 5 days. Diestress period in case of cattle is 13 days. Buffalo is 11 to 15 days. Horse is 6 to 10 days, in case of swine is 13 days, in case of sheep is 7 to 10 days, goat is 7 to 10 days, while in case of dog is 6 months, which is very large. 20. Number of progeny produced per parturition of sow are option A 10, option B 14, option C 7, option D 9. The right answer is 14. If we see that camel, cattle, buffalo, horse, this all animal has number of progeny. Per parturition is one baby. Sometime rarely that's twins may occurs. While in case of swine, number of progeny produced per parturition is 14. In case of sheep is 1 to 3. In case of goat is 1 to 6. In case of dog is 5 to 6, in case of cat is 1 to 12. Question number 21st. Suborder Perissodactyla refer to even toe ungulate, B odd toe ungulate, C carnivorous, D pouched animal. The right answer is B Perissodactyla. Since there are two suborder, odd hoofed animals comes under suborder Perissodactyla, while even hoofed animals comes under Artiodactyla. And other than that, pouched animals which have pouched like kangaroos called marsupial. Question number 22. Study of animal behavior is called option A etymology, option B behaviorology, option C ethology, option D ethos. The right answer is option C ethology. Actually, etymology is the study of origin of word. It is other than related to the biology. And while the word behaviorology is a study of nothing, this word is not exist. Okay, question number 23. Split stress occurs in which of the following animal? Option A goat, option B ewe, option C cow and option D mare. The right answer is D mare. Actually, in mare, split head as well as gestation head and full heat, all three type of heat are occurs in mare. Split heat also seen in dog as well. Split heat is a heat that happening in two distinct period of time and which is break by a certain period of time. And gestation heat refer to that when animal comes into the heat while at the time of pregnancy, and foal heat that immediate heat after parturition. In case of mare, it came by 6 to 8 days of postpartum. Question number 24. Time of ovulation in cow is option A, 10 to 15 hour after end of stress. Option B, 12 to 24 hour after end of stress. Option C, 10 to 15 hour before end of stress. And option D, 12 to 24 hour before end of stress. The right answer is option A, 10 to 15 hour after end of stress. Actually, in case of cattle, if we see that the actual ovulations occur during metastress period, that is 10 to 18 hour after end of stress. While in case of mare, that is last stress, that is last 2 days of stress. In case of ewe, that's last day of stress. In case of goat as well, last day of stress. While in case of sow, that 30 to 40 hour start of stress, and then bitch, that is first 3 days of stress. While in case of cat, because it is an induced ovulator, so that ovulation occurs only after the mating. Like cat, camel and rabbit, we all know that these three are induced ovulator. Question number 25. Which animal has maximum semen volume? Option A, horse. Option B, boar. Option C, bullock. Option D, dog. The right answer is boar. In case of boar, the boar ejaculate 250 ml atoms. Like in case of cattle, it's 8 ml. In case of mare, is 125 ml. In case of ewe and doe, that is 1 ml. In case of sow, it's 250 ml, which is very high. In case of bitch, it's 10 ml. In case of cock, that is 0.5 to 0.75 ml, which is highly concentrated semen. Which minerals is highest in fish? Option A, sodium. Option B, chlorine. Option C, potassium. And option D, sulfur. The right answer is option C, potassium. Actually, fish is rich in calcium and phosphorus, and as well as it's also the great source of minerals such like iron, zinc, iodine, magnesium and potassium. Question number 27. Which of the following animal have maximum sperm in 1 ml of ejaculate? We already seen the questions where boar has the large amount of ejaculate of semen per ejaculation, and now it's time to see that highly concentrated semen. Since the lower the amount of the semen per ejaculation, that higher the concentrated of the semen. So in this case, the cock, option number B, the right answer is option number B. Cock has highly concentrated semen. After that cock, the highly concentrated semen is of ram and followed by doe. Okay. Question number 28. Temperature required for storage of liquid semen storage in ruminant is 15 degree centigrade, B 10 degree centigrade, C 5 degree Celsius and D 20 degree Celsius. The right answer is option number C, that is 5 degree Celsius. Actually, in case of cow and ewe and doe, that liquid semen storage at the temperature of 5 degree Celsius, while in case of horse, doe and sow, the liquid semen is storage at temperature of 15 degree Celsius, while frozen semen storage at temperature of -196 degree centigrade. Question number 29. Which of the following animal has maximum number of behavioral sperm per ejaculate? We already seen that highly concentrated sperm is of cock, and the highly largely volume semen is of boar, and now it's time of that highly behavioral sperm per ejaculation. The option A, ram. Option B, stallion. Option C, dog. And option D, buck. The right answer is buck. Okay, in we see that EU and DOI both case that the viable sperm percentage is 90%. In case of followed by mare, that is 70%, and then followed by cattle and sow, which is 60%. Question number 30. Which of the following animal have silent heat? Option A, cow. Option B, buffalo. Option C, goat. Option D, sheep. The right answer is buffalo. Silent heat in animal refer to that animal showing the heat without any sign of stress. So it is very difficult to recognize that either animal is in heat or not because it doesn't showing any kind of sign. So doing AI in such type of animal is very difficult. And so silent heat is not shown by buffalo only, it is also shown by bitch as well. Question number 31. Cow should be bred in days postpartum. After parturition, how many days after the parturition the cow should be rebred again? Okay, option number A is 10 to 13 days. Option number B is 13 to 15 days after postpartum. Option number C is 15 to 18 days after postpartum. Or option number D, that is 60 days after postpartum. The right answer is option D, 60 days after postpartum. In case of that cattle, the fertile heat after postpartum is 60 days. It is too long. It is too long because during middle time, the cow's uterus needs time to regenerate itself again. So it can maintain pregnancy again. Okay. And mare is 25 days after postpartum, pig 14 days after postpartum, in case of goat 4 to 6 weeks after postpartum, in case of sheep is after only 3 months postpartum. Question number 32. Duration of heat occurs in sow in hours postpartum is? Okay, after parturition, after how many time of parturition the animal came in heat again? Option number A, 12 hours. Option number B, 24 hours. Option number C, 48 hours. Option number D, 60 hours. The right answer is 48 hours. Okay, so come immediate heat after parturition after 48 hours. In case of cattle, the immediate heat occur after parturition is after few week to 2 months of parturition. In case of horse, the immediate heat seen after 5 to 7 days, that is also called foal heat. After parturation, which heat in sow is fertile? Okay, option A, 48 hours postpartum. Option B, 14 days postpartum. Option C, 48 days postpartum. Option D, 14 hours postpartum. The right answer is B, 14 days postpartum. Although the immediate heat occur 48 hours after postpartum, but at that time the animal is not able to sustain another pregnancy. So that type of heat, immediate heat should be skipped in all animal. Question number 34. Uterus involutes to its normal size days postpartum in cow. Option A, 45 days. Option B, 28 days. Option C, 48 days. Option D, 30 days. The right answer is 45 days. Uterine involution is referred to the process in which there is a reduction in the size of the uterus as well as the remodeling of that endometrium layer of the uterus so that uterus can sustain and initiate another pregnancy. It's mainly include three major steps like myometrial contractions and expulsion of the lochia, second restoration of endometrium, as well as eliminations of bacterial contamination from reproductive tract. Question number 35. Age of sexual maturity in dog is 10 to 12 month, B, 12 to 18 month, C, 18 to 24 month, or D, 24 to 30 month. Actually, the age of puberty and age of sexual maturity is not same. The age of puberty is that age at which the animal shows first stress sign, or second one is that first ejaculate. Or second was that at age of sexual maturity is that age where that animal is able to conceive, when the animal is able to sustain pregnancy, that is known as age of sexual maturity. In case of cattle, the age of puberty is 6 months to 1.5 years. and while sexual maturity is 2 to 3 year, in horse 2 year followed by 3 year, swine 5 to 8 month and 8 month, ewe 4 to 12 month, 12 month, ewe 4 to 12 month, 12 month, canine 6 to 12 month, 12 month, feline 8 to 12 month, 12 month. Question number 36. Semen collection frequency of cattle time per week is option A 1, option B 3, option C 5, option D 7. The right answer is 3. In case of cattle and in case of boar, the semen should be collected 3 times in a week. But in case of buffalo, the semen should be collected once in a week only. Question number 37. Site of semen deposition is uterus. In which of the following animal? Option A boar, option B stallion, option C dog, option D both A and B. The right answer is option D, both A and B. In case of while in natural semination and artificial semination, okay, while in natural semination, in case of cattle, ewe, goat, dog, we see that the site of semen deposition is vagina. While in case of horse and swine, it's cervix and uterus. Similarly, while in artificial insemination, in case of cattle and horse, the site of semen deposition is uterine body. While in case of swine, it's cervix. While in case of ewe, is cervix and vagina. Questions number 38. Which of the following is the oldest domesticated animal? Option A, horse. Option B, dog. Option C, cow. Option D, camel. The right answer is dog. Actually, the goat was the first domesticated animal, followed by the sheep, and then cat, and then dog. But in above all option, there is no option of a goat and a sheep. So we choose the dog is the right answer. Question number 39. Which of the following animal have maximum dressing percentage? Actually, the dressing percentage refer to the weight of the carcass divided by the total live weight of the animal. Since edible carcass weight, okay, in option number A, goat, option number B, sheep, option number C, swine, option number D, cow. The right answer is swine, option number C. Since the dressing percentage is very much higher of chicken, that is 80 to 82%, followed by pork, that is 65 to 80%, followed by beef 50 to 60%, followed by chicken 48 to 50%, and the least reducing percentages of mutton, that is 45 to 55%. Question number 40. Age of weaning in goat in weeks is 14 weeks, B 16 weeks, C 18 weeks, D 20 weeks. The right answer is 16 week. While in case of a cow, the age of weaning time is 9 week of age. In case of swine, it's 8 week of age. In case of goat, is 16 week of age. And in case of sheep, is 14 week of age. Question number 41. Age of castration in cattle in week is 11 to 14 week, 16 to 18 week, 8 to 10 week. At D, 14 to 16 week. The right answer is C, 8 to 10 week. In case of swine, the age of castration is 1 week. In case of sheep is 2 week. In case of goat is 4 week. In case of cattle is 8 to 10 week. Question number 42. Age of dehorning in cattle in days is option A, 7 days. Option B, 10 days. Option C, 13 days. Option D, 16 days. The right answer is B, 10 days. The cattle should be dehorned as soon as possible within 10 days of age. Question number 43. Marketable age in month and body weight kg of swine are respectively. Option A, 6 to 8 month and 68 kg. Option B, 3 to 6 month and 36 kg. Option C, 8 to 10 month and 70 kg. Option D, 10 to 12 month and 180 kg. The right answer is A, 6 to 8 month and 68 kg body weight. In case of pig, the marketable age is 6 to 8 month and the marketable weight is 68 kg body weight. Things of cattle is that when cattle is 36 month of age, that it is marketable age of cattle, and at that time the weight of the cattle is 450 to 500 kg. While in case of sheep and goat, the marketable age is 5 to 8 months, and at that time their weight is 45 kg. In case of poultry is 45 days, and at the time of their weight is 2 to 2.5 kg body weight. Question number 44. Cattle female showing the sign of advanced pregnancy is known as option A, Springer, option B, Fultra, full fruit, option C, both A and B, option D is Fultra. The right answer is Springer. Okay. Question number 45. The feed conversion efficiency is maximum in option A, cattle, option B, poultry, option C, pig, option D, camel. The right answer is B, that is poultry. Actually, we heard about two terms, that is feed conversion ratio and feed conversion efficiency. If the feed conversion ratio is higher, it means that feed conversion efficiency is lower. Okay, that feed conversion ratio refers that the mass of the input, that is a feed, divided by the mass of the output. Okay, in order to produce 1 kg of carcass weight, yeah, 1 kg of milk, how much feed should be fed to the animal? That how much amount of the feed is required in order to produce 1 kg of body weight. Okay, and which is FCR ratio is highest in cattle, that is 8:1. That is 8 kg of feed is required to produce 1 kg of body weight of cattle. In case of pork is 3:9:1, chicken is 1:9:1, and fish is 1:3:1. So feed conversion efficiency is higher in case of fish, followed by chicken, followed by pork, and then followed by cattle. Question number 46. A smaller piglet of a liter which is expected to farrow at last is known as, that is all. Information that is related to swine productions and management. In case of detection of the swine, there is a most famous test is riding test. Since that when the standing heat in a pig which is detected by that while pressing to the manually pressing on the back of the show, that show remain still and erect is ear, then it means that the show is in heat. And blue pig is type of the pig which is produced by crossing the black and white pig, and brawn is the product that is prepared by boiling the meat of the pig head, and then trotter, that's mean of both foot, forefoot and hind foot both, and tail, that product is known as brawn. And maiden gild is a female pig of 6 to 8 month of age, and store pig are the pig between 8 to 15 week of age that is suitable for market as well. And sty is that house of pig having one or more pen for horse, and figure is a place where pig should be kept. Question number 47. Farming in which 50% or more opted from a single source is known as option number A, specialized farming, option number B, diversified farming, option number C, mixed farming, and option number D, none. The right answer is specialized farming. Farming which cooperate like both animal and crop production, that is known as mixed farming. And if there is a varieties of animal and that varieties of crops, then it is known as diversified farming. Question number 48. Dry matter requirement of buffalo per 100 kg body weight in kg is option A 2, option 2 2.5 kg, option C is 3, and option D is 3.5. The right answer is C, that is 3 kg. And in case of cattle, the dry matter requirement per 100 kg body weight is 2.5 kg. Since feeding system which is fed to that cattle and buffalo actually have two types, that is concentrate and roughages. And we fed concentrate is two-third part of the concentrate and one-third part of the one-third part of that concentrate and two-third part of the roughages. And concentrate requirement to cattle and buffalo is as follow. In order for the maintenance of that cattle to perform the vital performance, okay, that required 1 kg of concentrate daily, and for production, like in order to produce for every 3 kg of milk, वी शुड फिट दैट 1 kg ऑफ कंसनट्रेट एक्स्ट्रा एंड इनकेस ऑफ बफेलो दैट 1.5 kg फॉर मेंटेनेंस एंड फॉर एवरी 2.5 kg ऑफ मिल्क 1 kg कंसनट्रेट फेडेड एक्स्ट्रा. क्वेश्चन नंबर 49. क्रिप फीड फॉर स्वाइन शुड कंटेन 16% प्रोटीन, बी 18% प्रोटीन, सी 20% प्रोटीन एंड डी 24% प्रोटीन. द राइट आंसर इज 20% प्रोटीन. एक्चुअली द क्रिप फीड इज दैट फीड विच इज फीड टू द यंग वन दैट इज एट द टाइम ऑफ विनिंग. सो स्वाइन विनिंग राशन इंक्लूड सीपी परसेंट 20 to 22% and that energy, that's metabolism energy requirement is 330 to 360 kilocal. In case of growing pig, that is 18% CP and 3360 kilocal, and finishing that is 14% CP and 3170 kilocal metabolism energy, and breeding pig that is 14% CP and 3300 kilocal metabolizable energy, and lactating is 15% CP and 3300 metabolizable energy. Okay, question number 50. Daily requirement of protein in dog is option A 3 g protein per kg body weight per day, option B 5 g protein per kg body weight per day, option C 2 g protein per kg body weight per day, option